In this problem, we're asked to find the area bounded by the y-axis, the linear function f of x equals negative 1/3 x plus 6, and the line perpendicular to f of x passing through the origin. So the region is going to be bounded by the y-axis, which should be this vertical line here. Now let's go ahead and graph f of x. We have f of x equals negative 1/3 x plus 6, which is in slope-intercept form, or the form y equals mx plus b. So the y-intercept is equal to positive 6, which would be this point here. And the slope is negative 1/3, so from the y-intercept, go down 1 unit and right 3 units. So f of x passes through these two points. Now let's consider the line perpendicular to f of x passing through the origin. We know this line is perpendicular to f of x. Notice the slope of f of x is equal to negative 1/3. The line perpendicular to this will have a slope that's the negative reciprocal of negative 1/3, which means the second line will have a slope where we flip this over and change the sign, so the slope would be positive 3 over 1, or just 3. And because this line also passes through the origin, that means the y-intercept, or b, must equal 0. Let's call this line g of x. So g of x is going to be equal to 3 times x, or 3x, plus 0. We'll leave off the plus 0. Now let's go ahead and graph this line, which should be perpendicular to f of x. The y-intercept is 0. The slope is 3, or 3 over 1. So from here, we'll go up 3, right 1. And g of x passes through these two points. So the region bounded by these three lines is this yellow triangular region. So we want to determine the area of this triangle. Remember, the area formula for a triangle is area equals 1/2 base times height. So we need to find the length of the base and the height of this triangle. Let's let this side here be the base of the triangle. Notice how it has a length of 6 units. So this is 6. And then the height of this triangle, since this is the base, would be the distance from the y-axis to the point of intersection of f of x and g of x, the length of this segment here that's perpendicular to the y-axis. Well, this length here would actually be the x-coordinate of this point of intersection. The x-coordinate would give us the horizontal distance from the y-axis to this point of intersection. So the last step here is to find the x-coordinate of the point of intersection of f of x and g of x. Let's do that on the next slide. To determine the x-coordinate of the point of intersection, we need to determine when f of x is equal to g of x. Well, this will occur when negative 1/3 x plus 6 is equal to 3x. So let's set this up as an equation and solve for x. So we have negative 1/3 x plus 6 is equal to 3x. Let's go ahead and clear the fractions by multiplying both sides of the equation by 3. This would give us negative x plus 18 equals 9x. Go ahead and add x to both sides of the equation. That would give us 18 equals 10x. Divide both sides by 10. We have x equals 18 tenths. And because there's a common factor of 2 here, this simplifies to 9/5. So the x-coordinate of the point of intersection is 9/5, which would also be the height of this triangle. So the last step is to find the area of this triangle, where the base is 6 units and the height is 9/5 units. So the area is equal to 1/2 times 6, which will write as 6 over 1, times the height, which is 9/5. Let's go ahead and simplify. Here we have a common factor of 2 between 2 and 6. There's 1, 2, and 2, and 3 2s and 6. So our area is going to be 27/5 square units, because it's area, Or if we want, we can write this as 5 2/5 square units. And again, this would be the area of the bounded triangular region. I hope this was helpful.